In this question, we have to show the given equation represents an ellipse or not. And if it represents an ellipse, then we have to find its vertices, foci, eccentricity and directrices. So, we can write the given question as 4x square minus 24x plus 16y square minus 32y is equal to 12. And this again, we can just write it 4x square minus 6x plus 16y square minus 2y is equal to 12. Now, by the method of completing the square, what we are doing here? Adding half coefficient of x whole square and half coefficient of y whole square to both sides. Okay, so what we are getting, we will be getting now 4 x square minus 6x plus 9 plus 16 y square minus 2y plus 1 is equal to 12 plus 36 plus 16. Now remember one thing, I am just converting this equation in the whole square. So here 9 is added, but outside it is 4. So it means for this whole part we have added and subtracted 36. Both sides 36. So here 9 and here 36. Similarly, here we are adding 16, okay, because 16 is outside. So positive 16 this side and 16 that side, okay. So now this becomes x minus 3 whole square plus 16 y minus 1 whole square is equal to 64. Now dividing each term by 64, what we are getting? X minus 3 whole square upon, dividing by 64, it is 4, 16 plus y minus 1 whole square upon 4 is equal to 1. Now, translating the coordinate axis such that the new coordinates becomes capital X is equal to X minus 3 and capital Y is equal to Y minus 1. Okay, so what we are getting? We are getting x square upon 16 plus y square upon 4 is equal to 1, which represents an ellipse. First thing which we have done is the equation of an ellipse. Okay, now comparing the equation with x square upon a square plus y square upon b square is equal to 1, where b square is equal to a square 1 minus e square, we get a is equal to 4, b is 2, and on solving we will be getting e as root 3 by 2. okay, you can just solve it here. B square, it is 4. 4 is equal to 16, 1 minus e square. 1 minus e square is 1 by 4. And e square is equal to 1 minus 1 by 4. Okay, so we'll be getting root 3 by 2. Now, we are having original coordinates. X is equal to 3 plus x and y is equal to 1 plus y. Y is equal to 1 plus y and x is equal to 3 plus x. Okay. So, we are done with the original coordinates. Now, let's find vertices, foci, eccentricity. We have already done it. Eccentricity we got it and the directrix. So, under new coordinate system, under old, that is the original coordinate system. Now, here number one is vertices. Here vertices we are having plus minus a comma 0. Therefore, coordinates for the vertices are plus minus 4 comma 0. A we are having 4. Okay. So, here now, here vertices will be, vertices here it will be 3 plus x comma 1 plus y. Okay. 3 plus x, this one, and 1 plus y. So, vertices we will be having 3 plus minus 4 comma 0, or you can write it 1 plus 0. 1 plus 0. So, coordinates vertices are, now we are having 7 comma 1 and minus 1 comma 1. Okay. So, these are the vertices. Now, number 2, that is foci. Now, coordinates for foci we are having plus minus AE comma 0. Now, A is what? A is 4 and E is root 3 by 2. So, plus minus 4 times root 3 upon 2 with 0, and this becomes plus minus 2 root 3 comma 0. Okay, for this part now, for the original coordinates we are having f as 3 plus minus 2 root 3, this one AE, okay, 3 plus minus 2 root 3 comma, here it is 0, 1 plus 0. So, coordinates of the foci are now 3 minus 2 root 3 comma 1 and 3 plus 2 root 3 comma 1, or for f you can write it s1 or s2, okay, s1 or s2, anything. Then number 3, eccentricity. Now for eccentricity we have already solved it. Once again I can just do it. Now here, from here, just check from here, we are having e square is equal to 1 minus 1 by 4, this is 3 by 4. So, e is equal to root 3 by 2. And now, left with directrix. Number 3, now number 4. Directrix we are having x is equal to 3 plus minus a upon e. X is equal to 3 plus minus 4 upon root 3 by 2. So, x is equal to 3 plus minus 8 upon root 3. So, how many answers we are having? Answers First, answer for E, answer and one more, that was this one. This is also an answer.